Hello, my name is Komal Suryavanshi. I am a PhD student working under Dr. Prasad Kulkarni from Bioprospecting Group of Agarkar Research Institute, Pune. In our laboratory, we are mainly focusing on Alzheimer's disease. We are trying to understand the role of metal ions in the progression of Alzheimer's disease. Also, we are working on plant-based regenerative medicines for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease. Dementia in elderly population is an emerging global public health challenge. According to WHO report 2013, the total number of people with dementia worldwide in 2010 is estimated at 35.6 million and is projected to nearly double every 20 years. In India, between 1996 and 2006, around 2.7% of the population is affected by dementia. Alzheimer's disease is the most common form of dementia. It is characterized by progressive decline in cognitive functions. Symptoms of Alzheimer's disease typically appear after age of 60, which commonly includes memory loss, language problems, inability to recognize objects and faces, and difficulty in reading, reasoning, and problem solving. Alzheimer's disease is characterized by the presence of extracellular senile plaques, mainly composed of beta amyloid peptide and neurofibrillary tangles in the brain. These A-beta peptides form due to abnormal processing of amyloid precursor protein by beta and gamma secretase are highly toxic to neurons and considered as a promising target for Alzheimer's disease treatment. It has been observed that metal ions such as zinc or copper increase the stability of A-beta aggregates. It has been proposed that interaction of these metal ions with A-beta causes an increase in mitochondrial generation of reactive oxygen species, which further leads to neurotoxicity. Copper is an essential trace element, and alterations in cellular copper metabolism could lead to serious effects. In our lab, we are mainly focusing on the effect of copper ions in the progression of Alzheimer's disease. In vitro studies have been carried out using different cell lines such as SHSY5Y and BV2. These cells are seeded in the density of 1 into 10 to the power 4 cells per well, followed by treatment with different compounds to perform cell-based assays such as cytotoxicity assay, cellular uptake studies, nitric oxide assay. Also, confocal imaging is being performed. A number of inhibitors of A-beta peptide aggregation have been reported, which includes polyamides, chaperones, metal chelators, and nutraceuticals. Metal chelators are found to be effective in preventing metal-dependent A-beta peptide aggregation, deposition, and toxicity. Earlier, novel 8-thiosemicarbazone derivatives were synthesized in our laboratory and investigated for the inhibition of A-beta 1 to 42 peptide aggregation by several biochemical assays. We have evaluated the effect of these thiosemicarbazone derivatives on A-beta-induced cytotoxicity in SHSY5Y cells. We observed that amongst these derivatives, 2 thiosemicarbazone derivatives crossed the blood-brain barrier. Animal studies were carried out to further check the efficacy of these derivatives against progression of Alzheimer's disease in Wistar rats. Cognitive studies were carried out using methods such as Morris water maze and novel object recognition test.
Hello everyone, I am Padmaja Shetty, working with Bioprospecting Group Agarkar Research Institute, Pune. To address this Alzheimer's disease issue, we are using another aspect, that is molecular biology, in which we are studying metal ion transporter genes like copper, which have crucial role in cellular functions like metal uptake, transport and utilization. To check the effect of excess of copper and amyloid beta on copper transporter genes, we are using SHSY5Y neuroblastoma cell line. We are treating these cell lines with different concentration of copper and amyloid beta peptide. After treatment, extracted RNA samples are going to be used for gene expression analysis. For these gene expression studies, we are using RNA-based technology like polymerase chain reaction, real-time polymerase chain reaction, and next-generation sequencing. These tools are very efficient and accurate to know the molecular basis of Alzheimer's disease. Our group also explores different medicinal plant extracts and check for their effect against progression of Alzheimer's disease. To check activity of these plant extracts, we use GMR amyloid beta-induced Drosophila melanogaster model of Alzheimer's disease. GMR Drosophila phenotypically gives roughness to the eyes. If any extract has activity against Alzheimer's disease, their progeny reverts phenotypic rough eye character and gives normal smooth eye expression.